Hello and welcome to Bob and Talk. In this video, I will show you how to use Colorways and how to work in the texture editor. I have opened a file that has a tote bag. I've already created the tote bag, and the tote bag has various stitching, 2-3 different materials. I have a piece of hardware. You could use, obviously, this feature not just for accessories, but for garments or anything else you like. So let's start with opening the file. I have both the 3D and the 2D window open, and come up here to the top right. Right now I have simulation in this drop-down menu. Just click on it and choose Colorway. This will open up the Colorway editor in your window. So here right now you see just one Colorway A, and this is the defaults, or actually the settings that we have created for this particular style. And you can see that you have Pantone chips right here with the various colors that we're using. We have our fabrics, we have our button, we have the various kinds of top stitching. Even if I haven't used all of the top stitchings here, I have everything that is in the object browser under top stitch, under fabric, and anything else that you might have used. Now navigate all the way up here to the little plus button, left click on it once, and it will create a second colorway. This is how you would create multiple colorways. Let's come up to the top and rename it to whatever you like. I'm gonna rename it to Colorway B, click return or enter, and now you have two different colorways. Obviously, you could name them anything you like. If you have some kind of branding or a collection, this could be whatever name you choose. Now, this second colorway copied or duplicated the initial one. Now we can start playing with each one of these settings here, each one of these materials, colors, and we can change or edit every single one of them. We could also add additional prints, let's say additional materials. You could edit anything you like. Now let's start working on our new colorway. Make sure that it is selected up here. So for example, right now I have selected colorway one. I'm gonna go to colorway two, or colorway B, and here I have leather lambskin. You can see once you left click or select that in the object browser which pattern pieces does it apply to, and you can select the one that you want to work with. Keep in mind that we're in this particular colorway. Let's say that I do want to change the color of this particular pattern piece, which is the handles for the bag. So I'm going to make sure that this has a check right here on the left side. Property editor window is open, and I'm going to come all the way down to color. You may need to click this desaturation on or off depending on what this color is. If it is a darker color, I would choose desaturation on so that we can change it to a lighter color. And let's do that. I'm gonna left click on this swatch and choose a light color. Let's do this blush color. You can see it changing up here, but nothing has happened up here in the colorway editor. In order to see that change, I can already see it here. It gives me the new Pantone chip. It gives me what it looks like here. But in order to see it up here in the picture, I have to click update, and that will update the picture itself. Now, see how I have a zoomed in window here? That's what I see here. If I come out a little bit and have maybe a different angle, I would have to update. And that's what I will see here in both pictures. So that reflects the view that we have in the 3D window. We have changed the color here, and we can also change any of the physical properties, change the displacement map, the texture, the normal map, but we can do a lot more in the actual texture editor. In order to do that, make sure that your basic parameters drop-down menu is open. Come under texture and navigate all the way to the right until you see open texture editor. Left click on that, and that gives us a window for the texture editor. Just click OK. This is just a pop-up menu to tell us about the desaturation texture that it shows in saturation when using texture editor. You can left click here if you don't want to see this message again. Click OK, and now we have access to the texture editor. In order to work down here, you do have to select that swatch. because you do have the option to create copies of this fabric or even add more and overlay, let's say, different prints, graphics, maybe a second material. We will play with adding more prints and graphics up here. On the top area, we do have a canvas of sorts, and you can zoom in and out so you can see better what the scale of your print or textures is. Up here on the left menu, we can change the width and the height, whatever works best for you. And here, the resolution right now is 300. That's really good. It can go down as low as 72, but keep in mind that just like in images, the higher the resolution, the better the image. So right now, we're gonna leave it as it is. I am left click. This is blue, you can see it, right? Gonna make sure that this eye is clicked so we can actually see our fabric. And we're gonna take a look at the options here on the right side. So we can play with the blend. We don't have multiple fabrics here yet, so I'm just gonna leave it as normal right now. We can also change the color from here and choose something that is brighter, lighter. You can control the color from here. We can create a more neutral, and you can see what the Pantone color is here. I'm gonna click OK. I don't have a print, so there's nothing to tile or repeat right now. So this is fine for me. I'm just gonna click apply. I don't wanna apply and close yet. I still wanna work in this window. So let's bring a print and see how we can make this more interesting. So I'm gonna click on add. And I have right now open a folder where I have a lot of prints. You should navigate to the folder where you have all of your textures or prints and choose something that works for you. So I'm going to choose this diamond print. I'm going to click open, and that's going to bring it up here. And you can see that it already applied it to my handles. Take a note of your edit tool here. You can rotate. You can change the direction of your print, and you can see how it changes in the tiles. But I do want to play with the scale. So come up to this middle arrow and see how that will affect everything. You can change the scale, the length, the width. You can stretch it out a little bit. So right now I'm gonna fit this, and now we can start playing with the modes that we have here. And here in the repeat, I have a choice of how this is gonna tile. You can choose the space, you can choose the shift. You saw that until I clicked on that, I did not see the repeat in the 3D window. So you can also choose if you want to extend to the other side. Right now it's on. We can be off. We can play with the desaturation again and change the colors. So right now I brought it back to a very muted. I don't like how this is tiling up here. I like to have a much better repeat. And you can clearly see that the repeat is up here, but we have only this selection because we changed the scale of this print. So if you wanna bring that, and you can see it changing here in the scale of the window, and you can change, you can also see how at the borders here in our tile pattern, how is it affecting the print and what it looks like here directly on the handle. And I am not happy actually with this scale being wider rather than taller. I'm gonna bring this back. Once you're happy with your print overlay, you can click apply, and that will apply it to the actual texture editor, to the colorway B. If you're ready and finished, you can click apply and close. If you want to create more variations here, you can, let's say, copy this print and create a second one. And for that one, you can also go through all of the various changes. You can change the color. You can overlay it in a different way. So let's say I choose something that is actually a dark blue. Keep in mind that you would need to change the opacity. And if you're not happy with that particular, you can always turn it off so you don't see it, or you can delete this colorway altogether. So I am back to my blue one. Again, if you want to change the color, you can come here, select a different color. And play around with all of these options. When you're happy, so this one is really pink now, so I'm gonna come back to my more of a beige color. Once you're happy with this fabric, you can apply and close, and that will create, that will go back to the colorway. You can update that to see the new changes. Again, it will give you the view that you have here. So if you want to zoom up a little bit and see the full accessory, then you have to navigate here in the 3D window, come to update, and then you will see that. Now, you can go through this process for every single one of them and edit options for your fabrics, for your stitching, for your buttons, for your hardware, and we will do that. But before we move forward, I just wanted to show something to you. So let's say we are still in the 3D window. If you wanted to change a fabric for both colorways at the same time, for example, for the body, I want to apply a different fabric. I will select that in the 3D window. Then I will come to my object browser and I will apply the fabric or material that I want. And you can see it here coming onto the body. If I update my colorways, you will see that it is now applied to both colorways. In this case, I have two different colorways and it applied it to both. So this is a universal change of a material or hardware or stitching. The colorways are still separate and you can click in here and then select the fabric that you want, a material that you want, and then play with that in the texture editor. But again, for a universal change of a material or anything else for all colorways, you will do that here in the object browser. Now let's move on to working on hardware. So I will go to colorway B. Next here I have buttons. That's my hardware. Let's zoom in a little bit on this. I'm going to update this so we can see it better here. I will select my buttons because this particular piece of hardware was brought in as a button. This is the one that I'm working with. And under property editor, I do not have the option to open the texture editor, but I can make all of my changes here in the property editor for this particular colorway. I could change what this texture looks like. So I want to bring in a new texture here for this particular colorway. So I will click on this little square that will take me to my particular folder with button finishes. You have yours, and that could be whatever you have chosen. And let's say I would like this seashell tile. I will click open, and that will replace what I have here. Again, this changed it only for this particular colorway. If I update this, you will see the change up here now too. And you can see that now each colorway has different hardware. I'm gonna zoom out a little bit, update here so you can see the zoomed out version here. And the blue version, blue handles, has this particular horn button. This version has lighter handles and this particular hardware, which is more of those seashells. Next and last, I will play with my top stitching. I am still in colorway B. I'm going to scroll down here and select this three needle stitch. So that is this one. And here in the object browser, I also need to come to the top stitch navigation or top stitch tab. I will select, make sure that this is the one that it's in the property editor. And here I will take a look at the options that I have. I can change what kind of a stitch this is. Is it a top stitch or a trim, OBJ or a texture file? Stitch count, you could have more than one. Let's come down here. I could change, obviously, the shape of what kind of a stitch that is. I can change the length, space. You can change any of these. Maybe I will change the thread here. Maybe this is more of a leather, so it's a different thread. And let's change the color. So let's make this more of a light color to go with the pompons that are really light color. I will choose this. Click OK. You can see that it already changed here, but in order to apply the change here, I would also need to update, and that will bring the change in this window. You can see now that I have the navy here and I have the white here. And this is the process that you would go through to change and create different colorways. If I am ready with this one, I want to move to a new one, click plus. create a new colorway, make sure that that has a different names, and keep playing with the different options for materials, for hardware, for buttons, and anything else. If you're ready with this, you can also save the image and you can choose which way to save it. Once you're happy with your edits, you can save the whole file as it is, but you also have a couple of more options from the colorway editor. In this window, you have save image, and once you click on that, you have two different options. One of them is you could save just what's in the 3D window. So if you select 3D window and click OK, choose a name. So mine is a tote bag. Color, tote bag, snapshot, and you can call it whatever particular colorway you have selected or a particular view. And you can click on that and it will ask you, it will prompt you, what kind of an image do you want to save? Would you like to do a multi-view? Would you like to do a single view? If it's a single view, what are the presets in terms of orientation, portrait, or landscape? Keep in mind that whatever you have in the window, that's what you're going to see. You can select your width, height, resolution, and transparent background or everything else that you have. For multi-view, you can select what images you can have in that multi-view. First of all, how many? Would you like two? Would you like three, four, or more? So let's say I have four images. Then it's also going to ask you what is the layout, horizontal, vertical, box. If it's four, maybe I would prefer a box. Also have a choice of portrait or landscape. And if this is vertical or a box, you will see them however you choose. I'm going to choose landscape. I'm going to leave the width and the resolution. This is just a test or a sample for me. And then for each window, you can select what you have. So you have a drop down where you can just select what it is and you can take a picture. So for my front, it brought me to a full view from far away. If I don't like it to be so far away, I can zoom in and then click the little camera and it will take a snap of what's in the window. For presets, I could choose right, left, or whatever you like, let's say a three-quarter view, but again, this is a far away view. It literally takes a snapshot of whatever's in the 3D window. If you want a close up, I would bring it to the angle, ideally the scale that you like, and then I would just snap the camera, and I would do that for all of them. You could also choose bottom, top, whatever you like. Let's say I have some really pretty feet here, maybe some special hardware. I could take a snap of that too. And for this last one, I will choose a back view. My back view has the pompons. Maybe I want a close-up of my pocket and hardware. So I will take a snap of that. My multi-view is ready. Make sure you're happy with everything else here. Click save and choose a folder where this would go. That is in our Finder folder or wherever you saved it. So here's the snapshot that I chose. You can see the four different views, my close-ups, front, back, bottom, and everything else that you chose. You can choose more views and make multiples of these. You could also save an image in the color editor as what is actually in the colorway editor. Say okay, and give it a name, colorways, tote bag, choose where you would like to save it. And it literally took a snapshot of what is in my colorway window. So this gives me the option to take a look at what's in every single colorway, A, B, C, what are my colors, what are my materials, what are my stitches, and I can reference that for production or anything else that you like. If you like this video, if you learned something new, please click the like button, subscribe to Bob and Talk. This will help the YouTube algorithm. I'll be able to do more videos, and I'll see you next time with more knowledge for you.